Hey everyone, my name is Alex Johnson, and I am in FDMA 326, and this is musicals. This is my midterm exam project on musicals, so here we go. So let's talk first, what is a musical film? Well, it's pretty simple. A musical is a motion picture consisting of a plot integrating that musical numbers. The songs usually advance the plot and develop the characters, and usually the musical numbers in a movie are accompanied by a dance number or incredible production movement. Movie musicals are based off of a stage musical adaptation or vice versa. So that picture on the right side there is from The Greatest Showman, which was a live-action musical that came out a few years ago and won a lot of awards. But let's talk real quick about early film musicals. So on the left here, we got the Jazz Singer poster from Al Jolson. The Jazz Singer came out in 1927. It was directed by Alan Crosland, and it was the first musical ever to feature limp, synchronous singing and speech in several isolated sequences. So the movie itself features six songs, all of which are sung by Al Jolson. And this movie and its use of sound revolutionized the film industry. It ended the silent film era and it kicked off the modernization of sound in film. And due to the overwhelming success of this film, every production company literally raced to create musical film into the 1930s. They all wanted sound in their movies. So that's what makes The Jazz Singer such an influential movie, because it kicks off the next era, which is the 1930s. Right on the left side here, we got The Wizard of Oz, but then we got, in the 1930s, musicals became the most popular Hollywood genre. RKO and Warner Brothers were the main producers of the musical film during this time, but they were replaced by MGM in the 1950s. From the 1930s to the 1950s, stars like Judy Garland, Mickey Rooney, and Marilyn Monroe rose to fame because of musicals. And in the 1960s, film adaptations of Broadway musicals became incredibly popular, which paved the way for stars like Julie Andrews and Barbara Streisand to rise in popularity. So we can even kind of see that last point play out even today with Hamilton a few months back coming out. That was a stage play that was filmed and turned into a movie, and it was great. So you can really see the effect of that. Anyways, in the 1970s, this was the end of the classic musical era. So basically, there were tons of musicals for a long period of time, which were really great. We had so many great musicals back in the 1930s, 40s, 50s, and then up to the 60s, they released both Mary Poppins and The Sound of Music. Both dominated the box office. They're still super big hits today, and they gave Hollywood studios more confidence to produce lengthy, large-budget musicals. But the thing is when you have too much of something, it doesn't go too well. Because there was then just an abundance of musicals, and a lot of them ended up flopping at the box office. Audience didn't like them. It was just a disaster. And it just caused a big decline in popularity for movie musicals. And that happened in the 1970s. Then, here we are. After the 1970s, the demand for live-action musicals decreased. It just wasn't there. Besides Annie, the 1980s didn't produce any majorly successful live-action movies. I mean, Back in the 1980s, we were watching Jurassic Park and Star Wars and those types of good movies. But then, now here's something cool. In 1989, Disney released The Little Mermaid, which reignited the demand for movie musicals, this time in the form of animated movies. So then Disney released a large amount of animated movies in the 1990s. And these are classic movies. I mean, if you are a kid that grew up in the 2000s, you know these movies. I mean, Aladdin, Lion King, Nightmare Before Christmas, Mulan, Beauty and the Beast. These were great movies that everybody knows. And since this day, since this time, Disney musical movies have continued and are still being released to this day. So Disney really hit a home run there. They just produced a ton of great musical animated films in the 1990s. Then we moved on to the 21st century. Musical movies regained their popularity, with the lead distributor being Disney. Princess and the Frog, Enchanted, Frozen 1 and 2, Moana, The Muppets. These are just a few examples of movies that are musicals that are produced by Disney in the 21st century. Obviously, those are just Disney movies, but then actual other movies like Les Miserables, Phantom of the Opera, Sweeney Todd, Mamma Mia, Hairspray, Chicago, and Into the Woods. These are another just a few notable stage musicals that became successful film adaptations in the 21st century. So remember how we were talking about a few slides ago about how the stage musicals and the film musicals, they go hand in hand. And so the directors of these films, they saw the plays and they were like, oh my gosh, that would make a great movie to be put up on a musical. And it just happened just like that. And then we're looking at even more recent films like Greatest Showman, Rocketman, Straight Out of Compton. I mean, these Bohemian Rhapsody, all of those have just become such great iconic movies. I even forgot to mention it in here, but A Star Is Born as well. Not just the original one that happened way back in the 1900s, but the new one that just came out last year with Lady Gaga. I mean, they scored big at the Academy Awards. So definitely, it just shows that musicals are not dead. But now let's talk real quick about the best musical of all time. So obviously this is just my opinion, but I just wanted to share the, in my opinion, the best musical of all time has to be La La Land. I mean, this movie is just so captivating in every single way. It just electrifies the screen every time I watch it. And I've watched it a couple times. And I just think the acting is great. The characters are great. And it was directed by Damien Chazelle. It was nominated for 11 Academy Awards, winning Best Film, Director, Actress, Cinematography, and the Best Film Music. So the movie La La Land, it centers around an aspiring actress and a jazz musician who fall in love, but when they're offered the opportunity to have their dream jobs, they ultimately have to choose between true love for one another or the success in life. And I'm not going to spoil it if you haven't seen it, but you should definitely watch this. It's such a polarizing tale about two people and they just fall in love, and the music in it and the musical numbers and the cinematography, everything about this movie is just 10 out of 10 for me. And it made over $486.5 million in box office revenue. That's a lot of money. Okay, but long story short, the impact of musicals in film. So we're talking about the first synchronization between film and audio. It completely revolutionized the way that we view movies. When The Jazz Singer was released in 1927, musicals were an entirely new concept to audiences, and most silent film directors refused this new development and assumed it was just a passing phase. They just thought, oh, sound, it's gonna go away. But since then, they were quite wrong, because musicals have changed the way audiences have interpreted movies. Most musicals have catchy tunes and, for the most part, a happy ending. The feeling of walking out of a movie theater At least for me, after watching a wholesome story play out with a musical number still stuck in your head is a great feeling. And the inclusion of animated musicals has opened up new possibilities for the animated musicals targeted at children, as we see in modern-day Disney movies. Anyway, overall, movie musicals have had a significant impact on the movie industry. They have truly changed the face of film on how audiences interpret movies as a whole. Musicals are appealing to all ages and have lifelong impacts on the viewers. And that is why musicals are some of the best films, in my opinion, and they're great. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and take care.